is this known the darkness of a broken world until this time as Christ will come again.
Thank you. he becomes a child. No one in the world ever suspected that the Ancient of Days, who presided at creation, would take his throne in that creation as a babe in a crib. Just as no one ever thought that he would tell the old men of 40, like Nicodemus, that they must be born again. According to all world standards, it is the aged who are learned. And yet, when wisdom came to earth, he was a child. And when wise men came to wisdom, they were told to be like children. Christmas, then, is the coronation of childhood, the glorification of the young whose hearts are simple, the proclamation to aging hearts that the world need not despair and die, because the fountain of youth has come into it to turn time backward, make old things young again.
Christmas. People, look, ease the time is near. is not that peace will come automatically, because Christ is born in Bethlehem. The birth in Bethlehem was the prelude to his birth in our hearts by grace and faith and love. Peace belongs only to those who want to have it. If there is no peace in the world today, it is not because Christ did not come, it is because we did not let him in.
Was with child. While they were there, the time came for her to have her child.
chosen men, tabernacled himself in the world he had made, and you will see that only the simple and the learned found him, namely, the shepherds and the wise men. The angels in a star caught in the reflection of that light as a torch lighted by a torch, and passed it on to the watchers of sheep and the searchers of skies. And lo, as the shepherds watched their flocks about the hills of Bethlehem, they were shaken by the light of the angels. And lo, as wise men from beyond the land of Media and Persia searched the heavens, the brilliance of a star, like a tabernacle lamp, in the sanctuary of God's creation, beckoned them onto the stable where the star seemed to lose its light in the unearthly brilliance of the light of the world.
Their days are passed in loneliness and weariness, all
each hour might have been filled with sweetness. To such hearts, a single moment of grace may work the change. They suddenly become aware that the Lord is in the house. Better still, the Lord is in their hearts. They are no longer self-centered now, but they are God-centered. Outer events of their lives can no longer ruffle their peace. May Advent and Christmas be for us all a personal journey of transformation from the self-centered to the God-centered, from green logs to kindling, from outer chaos to inner peace.